بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. Dear viewers everywhere, I greet you with the best greeting ever known by humanity. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Peace be unto all of you everywhere in the world. Today we have one picture which is different from other pictures that we've seen in the previous episodes. First of all, it talks about the beloved ones, our children. Look at this picture, you will find it represents a lot of beautiful meanings that we need to apply in our life. First, there are two young children. I think they are around 4 years old or a little bit older. It seems that the blonde boy is feeding the non-blonde girl with ice cream. And you know in particular that how children loves ice cream. Children love ice cream very much. But it shows something more than love. It shows that although this young child loves ice cream like most of us do, he shares what he loves. He shares the ice cream that he loves with this girl. This beautiful meaning that's represented in the concept of sharing is something that we really need to reinforce. I'm not going to say that we're missing. We do have it. A lot of people have the sense of sharing. Yes, but we need to spread it. We need to make it part of our DNA. We make it to be part of ourselves. We need to live it day and night, not just things that we speak. And this whole religion is one main concept of it is sharing. Sharing what you have, sharing the knowledge that you have, sharing the wealth and the money that you have, sharing the time that you have. Man Canada, whoever has fadl, something extra, would share it with others, as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said it in many beautiful hadith that he said it. If you have something extra, you share it with others. And much better than something extra, if you have something that you love it, you share it with others. And that's why we, for example, as Muslims, we are asked, if you have a guest at your home, you present whatever you have. And as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala taught us, and Allah as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us, being taught by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that you are not considered good believers until you share what you love. Not the same thing that you don't use or you don't like. No, whatever you love, you share it with others. Because this is under the concept of ithar, that's loving for others more than what you love for yourself. Not just love for yourself, what you love for others, as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, but loving what you love for others more than what you love for yourself. This is really shows that you are a very good caliber of a human being, because you resist loving yourself and you try to take this love to others, because this is the sense of empathy. What would you do if you are in the position of that place, that person, or that this person or that person? What would you do? Would you love that this person would share what he or she has with you? The answer, of course, yes, I do love that. And because of this concept, you have to have this feeling of empathy. You put yourself in his shoes or in her shoes, and you see that. And that's why this great religion of Islam trains us and coaches us to develop this. In Ramadan, you share the food you have. When you have a guest, you share the food. You share everything that you have with him or with her. Yes, you welcome them. It is the right of a Muslim when he visits another Muslim, yes, to enjoy this hospitality. It's almost an obligation on every Muslim to do that. So when you learn sharing, and I think this picture, though, it shows just young children, but in reality, we need not the children, just the children to learn from this. We need the adults to learn from this. And instead of trying to keep everything for yourself, particularly when you know that in Islam, we believe that the concept of everything that we have is considered amana, trust from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The money or the properties that we own are not ours. They are something, a gift, are given to us from Almighty Allah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to see us how we use this property, how we use this trust that had been given to us. This money does not belong to you in reality. It belongs to Almighty Allah, and He gave it to you. And when you have this in mind, you want to use it and utilize it in the best way that would please Almighty Allah, because this trying to please Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is an explanation of, or a representation or an application of the meaning of that you submit yourself, even the likes and the dislikes. Sometimes we like things, but it is not disliked in Islam. Allah commands us to leave it, right? And we are doing this to please Allah, to show that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to show Allah that we submit ourselves to Him and not to our desires. It's a very beautiful meaning, and we need to spread this. And I think it is our job, the job of the parents, the job of the imams, the job of the teacher, to teach these beautiful values that would help humanity. But this is not just a value, it is a religious, or more specifically, it is an Islamic value. Because values differ from one country to another, or one culture to another, one tribe even to another, but this is an Islamic value. And what I mean by Islamic value, it is a divine value. It is something that was given to us to apply. So let's do this, let's spread it. Let's the media spread these beautiful meanings. Let the schools that we send our kids to do this job for us. Let every parent be responsible and try to teach his kids and himself and his family members this sharing, and not only on the level of children and adults. We wanted to move to the level of organizations and to the level of nations. We hope that one day this beautiful meaning would spread and become a common culture among all humans, so that everyone would have empathy with others and everyone would love for others what he or she loves for himself or herself. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us of those who apply what we learn from the beautiful things into others, in order to make the world a peaceful place, a place that's comfortable for every human being. May Allah guide us to the truth. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. Amduh Nuruddin Muhammad.